वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू यू ऑल स्टूडेंट्स. हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड आई होप यू टुक पार्ट इन डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ कॉम्पिटिशन्स हेल्ड ऑन पेट्रंस डे एंड यू एंजॉयड ऑल्सो. सो स्टूडेंट्स, वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द सेम चैप्टर, दैट इज एसिड बेसिस एंड सॉल्ट्स. प्लीज ओपन पेज नंबर 21. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट रिएक्शन ऑफ मेटलिक ऑक्साइड्स विद एसिड्स. Okay, and students, please keep on revising whatever is explained to you. Please keep on revising. Okay, so reaction of metallic oxides with acids. What are metallic oxides? Metallic oxides means oxides of metal. Now, how you will write sodium oxide? That is Na2O. So this is a metallic oxide. Okay. Now students, these metallic oxides, please pay attention, these metallic oxides are called as basic oxides, or you can say these metallic oxides are basic oxides, and in water they form bases. Okay, what they form? They form bases. Just remember, now these metallic oxides, please see here, metallic oxides which are basic oxides and which also behave as bases, when they react with acids they give salt and water. Why they give salt and water? Because this metallic oxide, it is a basic oxide. Basic oxide means it behave as bases. So bases and acids, or acid and bases, they give salt and water. Understood? Now you take the example of any metallic oxide. Let us take the example of sodium oxide. So this is a metallic oxide. This is a metallic oxide, means a basic oxide. Basic oxide, or you can say it behaves as base in water. So this, when it reacts with acid, it will give you salt and water. So what is salt here? NaCl plus H2O. Understood or no? So this is the reaction, and you can balance it. This is 2, sodium 2, oxygen is 1, hydrogen is 2. So understood? Is it clear to all of you? Now this is a metallic oxide. Now non-metallic oxide is a acidic oxide. Okay, so any non-metallic oxide, if you will take, that non-metallic oxide is a sodium oxide, acidic oxide. Now when this acidic oxides, when these acidic oxides will react with base, what you will get? You will get salt and water. Acidic oxides, when it reacts with what? Base. Now this acidic oxide, it is this non-metallic oxide is an acidic oxide, okay, or you can say it behaves as acids. So when it will react with base, what you will get? Salt and water. Is it clear? Again I will repeat, basic oxides, metallic oxides are the basic oxides which behave as bases. So these basic oxides, when react with acids, will give salt and water. Non-metallic oxides are acidic oxides, or they behave as acids, and when these acidic oxides, when they react with base, you get salt and water. Is it clear, students? So now these questions we will do later on, but before that we will discuss about this. Students, just refer section 2.2. What do all acids and all bases have in common? Now students, just see here, you take this beaker here, just see here, you just take this beaker, can you see? Now here this is a rubber cork, here these are two nails, and through the wire it is connected to the 6 volt battery and bulb and a switch. Now here, one by one, first you take glucose, then you take alcohol, hydrochloric acid and sulfuric acid. okay. So one by one you take these solutions and just close the switch and observe whether the bulb glows or no. So when you will take glucose in this solution, what you will find, you will find that bulb will not glow. Here if you will take alcohol, then again you will find that bulb will not glow. Now here if you will take acids like hydrochloric acid and sulfuric acid, you will observe that the bulb will glow. So what does it means? Okay, so this I have summarized this activity in short. So what you will find, when acids are taken, the bulb glows, which shows that the acids conduct electricity. How? Now students, glucose, the formula of glucose is glucose is C6H12O6. Okay, this is glucose. Now you take alcohol. So the formula of alcohol is C2. This is ethyl alcohol. Now what happens when these are taken, when it is taken in a beaker, the bulb will not glow. Why the bulb will not glow? Because here it does not dissociate or break into ions. Okay, ions are not formed. Is it clear? Ions are not formed. It has hydrogen atom, but it is not changed into ions in water. If you dissolve glucose in water, ions, H positive ions, are not formed. Same in case of alcohol also. In case of alcohol also, though it has hydrogen atoms, but here H positive ions are not generated in water. Ions are not formed. So therefore it doesn't conduct electricity, it doesn't allow the electricity to pass through because ions are not formed here. Whereas when we take hydrochloric acid, this hydrochloric acid, when it is taken in water, the H positive and Cl negative ions are generated. In case of sulfuric acid also, if you take sulfuric acid also, then also ions are generated. Okay, and you will find that the bulb will glow because these ions allow the electricity to pass through, or the electricity is carried by these ions. That is why the bulb glow. And whereas in case of glucose, when glucose and alcohol, these two solutions are taken, the bulb does not glow because in water they do not generate ions and the current is carried by ions. Is it clear? They have hydrogen, alcohol also has hydrogen, but then also the bulb does not glow or the electricity is not conducted. So acids, they conduct electricity because they form ions in water. Is it clear to all of you? Okay, now please see this question. Question number one. Why should curd and sour substances not be kept in brass and copper walls vessels? Just remember, curd and sour substances should not be kept in copper and brass vessels. Why? Because students, curd and other sour substances, okay, they contain what? They contain, see here, acids. Here you can see, okay, they contain acids which react with metals, because copper and brass are metals, so they can react with metals. And they form poisonous metal compounds, which can cause food poisoning and damage our health. Is it clear? So that is why they are not kept in brass and copper vessels, because you know that the metals, they react with acids to form salt and liberate hydrogen gas. Which gas is usually liberated when acids reacts with metal? That is very easy. What is the gas which is liberated? Hydrogen gas is liberated. Illustrate with the help of an example. How will you test the presence of this gas? So this is simple. This experiment that is shown in the book also, that is given in the book also. So this metal, zinc, when it will react with acids, salt and hydrogen gas is liberated. And what is the test for the hydrogen gas? The presence of hydrogen gas can be tested by burning it. When a lighted matchstick is brought near the gas jar containing hydrogen gas, it burns with a pop sound, making a little explosion. So question number 3 is your homework. Is it clear? So students, today we will do till here only, and rest we will do in the next class. That is what happens when acid and bases they react, and about pH. Okay. So if you have any doubt, you can clarify your doubts. Please revise chapter 1. I am in the next class. I may ask questions from chapter 1 also. I may give you some questions to do in the class work also. So please start revising your chapters. Okay. If you have any doubt, please clarify your doubts during clarification session. Thank you. Have a nice day.